college, honey. It was quiet here without you.
Yeah, it's good to have you back, kid.
Yeah. It's good to be back.
So, Spell, how's college? How's the psych program? Any girlfriends?
Oh, actually, Mom and Dad, there's something I want to talk to you about.
Okay.
They say that you really find yourself in college, and I was trying to, and Mom, Dad, I guess what I want to tell you is I want the D.
Son, is this truly what your H desires?
It is.
Of course I still love you, son. It's just gonna take a little bit of time to get used to. But my son wants the D.
He does, and I love him.
Spooky Castle was substantially worse than the alligators, but I counted this money, and it's about $20,000,000,000.
Wait, by my calculations, accounting for inflation, that'd be worth $200,000,000,000 in 1940.
What were they doing with that money? Wait, did you guys realize? That means that in 1840, it would have been... Laura! for $1,000,000,000!
Wow! If we were in 1840.
Oh my God.
Guys, this isn't 1840, okay? It's 2010. And we need to figure out. I mean, the plot of land the treehouse is on only costs $20,000. What are we gonna do with the rest of the money?
We can split it evenly.
Fuck off, Fred.
We could burn the money or bury it in like a deep hole.
We just dug it out of a hole, so I don't know if we want to bury it again. And burning it could work, but is also illegal.
We can donate it to charity, guys.
Fred, as your friend, I want to tell you you're embarrassing yourself right now. The castle changed now.
Wait.
What?
Oh, I have an idea. I'll go.
All right.
Reverse bake sale.
Okay, I guess I'll just go then. Tontine.
What's that?
I guess we would just buy a bunch of baked goods.
A tontine is when a bunch of people who have a bunch of money.
Like us.
Yes, exactly. Just wait until there's one person left alive, and that person gets all of the money.
But we're not allowed to kill each other.
What?
Well,
I think that we should do it.
It's a worth a shot.
Oh, fuck you and your
Hello, everyone. I'm Mrs. Sternstein, third grade teacher, and welcome to Sandra Day O'Connor's Middle School, final round of our annual Smelling Bee. First up, Bobby Brackett.
Is that a tennis ball?
That's correct! Great job, Bobby. Okay, next up we have Carol Connors.
Woo! Yeah, Carol.
Ahem.
I'm sorry, is there something I can help you with?
Oh, I wouldn't know. I just heard there was a meeting of the Devil Rider biker gang in this here bar.
What was that?
I said I heard there was a meeting of the Devil Rider biker gang in this and here bar.
Oh, the Devil Rider biker gang, eh? Yeah. And what would you know about the Devil Rider biker gang?
Well, I was thinking it's about time I get to join them. You know, especially seeing as I just burned down a liquor store. Oh. That is, not before drinking all the liquor therein and subsequently setting my liquor piss on fire, that's all.
Sure, sure.
Hey, you wouldn't say hey if you knew that, I just stole this Harley Davidson brand leather jacket off a whole pile of stolen Harley Davidson brand leather jackets that I burned and then threw a Harley Davidson brand motorcycle on top of that I fucked while it burned!
Listen, punk, the Devil Rider biker gang is about a lot of things. But it's not about burning down liquor stores and fucking motorcycles. It's about one thing, and about one thing only. It's about sincerity and having each other's backs. And it's about lying about cool shit you've done. Welcome to the Devil Rider Biker Gang! Ontario chapter!
Ronnie, Maya, it's just you two now. And Maya, you can still surrender if you come out now and give us your gun. We'll let you be on our team.
Maya?
All right, Ronnie, don't worry. I'm gonna do what they call a fake surrender. All right, I'm gonna go out like I'm looking to surrender. I'm gonna show my gun at the first possible opportunity. So then the surrender doesn't count, okay?
I trust you.
You trust me?
Yes!
Give it up, Ronnie! It's all over!
Yeah.
All right, Ronnie. It's just you now. You want to surrender like a gentleman?
I bow to no man.
Yeah. Hi, Jenny.
Then I'm going to shoot you.
I bow to no man!
Yeah.
No, boy. Ronnie's not cheating. Ronnie lives by rules that are yet unwritten, and today, he dies by them!
No!
First time I saw her on the piazza, there was this magnetism. I mean, just to look at her. But then when I heard that sweet, sexy Italian language, on top of the never-ending sound of her voice and the toxic incantation of it all, well, I couldn't understand a word of it, of course. Pardon me. I just saw you from across the piazza, and, well, I had to say something.
Ciao.
Hello.
speak English?
Il mio favorito colore è arancia.
My favorite color is orange.
Oh, how I wish you could understand my words. But perhaps you can see how I'm feeling.
C'è sole oggi.
It's sunny today.
Yeah, you know, I've taken about a semester to learn Italian. But the thing of it is, my past relationships, I mean, communication had been one of the biggest problems, so what was the point? I mean, sometimes it felt like no one would understand me, no matter what language I was speaking. Oh my god.
All the time I spent with Megan, I was entranced. I was enthralled by her. And knowing that she couldn't understand my words, I could be completely honest with her. There was no fear. Oh, Megan, you native Florentine woman. You are so beautiful.
Per il mio antipasto.
For my appetizer, I will have the bruschetta.
Oh, how I wish you could understand the poems I would write you, if not for your native tongue of Italy.
Mi piace il gatto.
I like the cat.
No, Megan, it's not enough. You must know, you beautiful creature. I must find a way to show you how I feel.
John. Nella mattina, io mi sveglio alle otto e mi pettino e faccio la doccia, ma io sempre mangio I cornetti, John, I cornetti! Vado all'università e lavoravo in un ufficio.
In the morning, I wake up at 8 a.m. I take a shower, comb my hair, and dress myself. For breakfast, I have croissants. Croissants! I study in a university and work in an office, John.
He understood me more than I thought was possible.
Wait, what?
Cool. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, happens to the best of
them. My allergies.
Well, I'm hoping to make a certain gentleman disappear while I go too. His name's Frankie.
I know a couple of cats who could, you know.
Seriously, do you need water? Are you okay?
It's just, these are
the veins on your neck.
I'm filtered, huh?
Oh my god.
Yeah.
All right. Well, how much is it gonna cost me?
That's really important today. Cyberbullying. Please be quiet, children. I would like to take a moment to introduce my nephew and intern, George Papadopoulos. Please, George. Okay, cyberbullying. Shh, shh. Cyberbullying. Do any of you know what that is? No, you don't. You know why? Because if you knew what it is, you wouldn't be doing it. You wouldn't be doing it, all right? So let's break it down. Cyberbullying. Cyber, from the Greek word, kismata, meaning internet. From the Scottish word burris, meaning to be rude. Let's put them together, shall we? Cyberbullying, to be rude online. All right, how do I reach these kids? All right, I'm gonna try to make it more real for some of you. Excuse me, miss, what is your name?
Leah.
Leah! Let's say Leah goes on a camping trip with all her friends. She uploads a picture of herself, but she doesn't realize that there was a flashlight in her pocket, the angle of which the photo is taken makes it look like Leah has a full erection. Is it polite? Is it polite? Is it polite to point out that the flashlight sort of resembles an erection? Please! Please! Please do not eat those! Please do not eat those! Mark! Please! Please do not eat those! Those are for a later part of the presentation! Mark!
God damn it!
Go! Go get them! Oh my god! Please don't eat them! Please do not! Get in her face, Mark! Get in her face! Get them back! Okay!
This is fine!
This is fine! We're rolling with it! Okay! Okay, there's a lot of things wrong with the world right now. Cancer claims millions of lives every year. India, more problems than we have time to talk about. Worse, who's gonna deal with that? But what he did here was a good point. He made a post on the internet, and it was harder for him to get it back than it was for him to spread out. Mark! Jesus Christ! Don't eat those! Please! Please do not eat those! Those are for the finale of the priest.
Do you want me to go?
No, fine, you can have them. Oh my god. Okay, we're gonna sum it up. We're gonna sum it up, guys. I'm really sorry about this. Oh my god. Okay, stop! Okay. When we waste time online, We are ignoring bigger problems in the world. It's petty. It's petty. And frankly, if we all spent a little less time posting behind each other's backs, we can make this world a sweeter place.
Interactions in ways that are set and unchanging. So every decision you're ever gonna make was just set, you know, from the big start of all the chemicals.
We've actually been in a lot of bio classes. We know how the universe works.
Yeah.
So you agree with me then? You get it?
No.
I don't know if the whole universe is, you know, made up of set and unchanging things and ways. And then why don't you just shoot yourself in the face right now.
No, you're a bag of chemicals, and they decided long ago, when the universe was first created, to do this, to shoot yourself in the head. Just do it.
Yeah,
just shoot yourself in the head. It's your
destiny. You have to.
Yeah.
There's nothing you can do.
Do it.
You must do it
in the head.
Yeah, so law school will give you more options. Midterm grade. No cheating.
But Mrs. Jenkins,
I don't have a pencil.
Damn it! You can go again. But excuses, Joe. Someday you'll take this test. Someday you'll take it! You will!
Not even apologizing, okay.
Well, no, I left you a message on the...
It's movie night.
I know, I told you I'd be late because I left you a message on the...
Beep. Hey, honey, it's me, your loving husband. I'm just here to tell you that, you know, I'm going to be a little late tonight, but don't worry, I haven't forgotten about movie night, and I just think you're the most swell woman in all the world, and I love you, can't wait to listen to you, and also I got the takeout.
Baby, what's wrong?
No, Fred, it's just, I was prepared. I was so ready.
And I was ready too. I really wanted to watch your little rice movie. What were you ready
for? I was ready to yell at you. I've been planning it for 2 hours, all the time I was waiting. And now, I was gonna yell at you and really give it to you, then walk out the door, but leave it open. Leave it open so you had to go and close it and think about what you did to me. It was gonna be great.
Yeah, no. You would have won that fight.
I know.
Hands down. But, honey,
if it makes you feel better, you can yell at me anyways if you want.
No.
No, no, Fred. You spent 2 hours. I was the one that was like, just Fred. Go ahead. Just go, I'll come in again. I'll come in.
You have some nerve, Fred. Come and come, you know? I know you don't care about gyro dreams of sushi, but I do. I know you don't care about gourmet sushi chefs or the documentaries they inspire, but guess what? I do, and it was my night to pick a movie, and when you picked, when you wanted to watch Shaolin Soccer or The Notebook, can I make a fuss? Did I? No! I came on time, and I stayed with you, but you know what? You don't have to stay with me. You don't even have to leave a message. I don't care anymore, Fred. I'm done.
Welcome to your first day of Spanish class. Okay, I know this course is mandatory, but I hope that with time, you too will learn to love La Lingua as much as I do. And in fact, it's gonna be imperative that you do, because if you wanna participate in our study abroad program, you'll have to get to, with real Spanish speakers.
I don't want to speak with real Spanish speakers.
Yeah, they're so weird.
They dance so strange.
Like the things they eat?
Carlton. Oh my god, and like their fleshy faces, you know?
That soft stuff on their heads.
So many limbs.
Oh, and their bones are on the inside.
I don't know, guys. I kind of like humans.
Yeah!
Mayor Baker?
Cannoli, this is true.
Who will eat us, Baker?
Well, Strudel, I didn't think of that. I suppose I will. All right. I have to take off my smock before I eat you. Don't you run anywhere while I'm gone.
Like we would go anywhere, Herr Baker.
We don't have legs, Baker! Could you imagine if we had legs? That'd be crazy! A field dream for scientists!
So zany, Linda.
Quick! My fellow pastries! I don't exactly have an abundance of time!
Kosher for Passover banana, woman!
The baker said you went stale. Kosher for Passover banana bread.
Stale! Stale, he said! Stale like a fox, maybe!
Kosher for Passover banana bread! How is it that you have arms and legs and are moving?
My friends, have you never wondered why the baker eats every pastry at the end of every business day?
Because he only wants the freshest of the pastries for his customers.
The baker has very high standards.
Yeah!
No! The baker's magic is more powerful than you even know!
What?
More powerful, dare I say it, than the baker himself!
Heresy!
After a day, if you don't get eaten, you grow legs and walk!
What?
What?
Oh!
Hey, first in and then out again, I have to go.
Who wants to go first?
Not me.
Yeah, keep talking, why don't you? I'll only blow your dirty head off, is all.
Kosher for Passover banana bread. You disgusting, large and legged deformity. I thought the pigeons in the park took good care of you.
Yeah, well, you're no Christmas postcard yourself. Friends, I can accelerate the light growing process. Hey, you do one nice thing. Would you at least eat my back first? It's been bothering me.
Sixth circle. Here you'll be whipped. Over there they're gonna put coals in your butt. What? What's your name?
Miranda.
How do you spell that?
M-E-R-A-N-D-A.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry, we made a mistake here.
Oh.
I gave him the gun.
I killed all those people.
I let a good man die.
Hello?
They can't see you or hear you.
Really?
Try it.
You walk funny. He's got a funny face.
I agree.
She's really pretty. You know, Martha was really pretty. But her light did shine bright as she was younger. Is it bad to notice your wife getting less and less beautiful every day? I mean, I've thought that she got more beautiful. Shouldn't I have at least stopped comparing her to other women? She deserved that. She shouldn't have had to compete with anyone. But she did.
I never even paid for my ma's operation.
I think I was a bad husband.
I killed him.
I don't deserve to wear this badge.
I was a bad husband.
Welcome to purgatory. Trip. I can't believe it took the death of Lenny to bring us back together.
I think we're all a little spooked for that Tontine thing. I know I'm watching my back.
You'd be a fool not to. I mean, I'm taking precautions. We're all going to hell anyway.
We killed that homeless guy.
Hey, we did not kill him. He choked on the cookies we gave him.
Yeah, but because we put Lego pieces in the battery.
Lenny thought it was a hilarious idea.
It was hilarious.
It was. What? Maria, what did you do to me?
It's true, Romans succumb faster to poison, isn't it?
What? Hey, is that the starburst I ate earlier?
This is the starburst you thought you ate. You ate some poisonous wax!
But it tasted just like starburst! Are starbursts just wax? I'm going to die now, Maria! Wait, no, let me have this. If I survive until tomorrow...
You definitely won't.
No, let me have this! If I survive until tomorrow, I get the treasure. Or at the very least, Mark doesn't get the treasure.
Why?
Because I poisoned you, Mark. I put a bagel in your coffee today.
What? Gluten? Are you kidding me?
No, Mark. No, Mark.
I am gonna die if I don't get to a hospital within 48 hours. Fuck! All right, my life's over. I might as well admit my sins. I killed Lenny. I choked him with a Lego piece.
Oh, shit!
Just like you did that old man. Who was me?
What?
That's right. I faked my own... Thank you. I faked my own death, and also that old man's. Because then you'd be more emotionally equipped to deal with it when I dies.
What?
I mean, I guess that makes sense, but like in a stupid way. Like, if I had to list the top 5 stupidest things I've heard.
Oh my god!
Yeah.
You shot me in the shoulder?
Yeah.
Honestly, I thought it would be a little more elaborate than that. Well, fuck you, Lenny. And you know what? Fuck you, Susan.
Fuck you!
Wait, nobody tried to kill Maria?
No, that was me. I defeated her, so she'd come to heart disease over the last years, but she just got really fat instead.
Okay, well...
Someone kill her.
Guys, if we don't all get to the hospital pretty soon, we're probably gonna die.
Yeah.
And also, it's becoming clear that each of us tried to kill one other person.
But... No one tried to kill everyone, just one other person.
Yet, no one tried to prevent their own death.
A tale as old as time.
A song as old as rhyme.
Hey, guys.
If everybody dies at the same time, who gets the treasure?
We all do.
Together.
It's worth a shot!
Go on, master, love life.